Love is but a song we sing. Fears we will die. You can make the mountains ring or make the angels cry. Though the bird is on the wing and you may not know why.
In 1968, almost every American knew what these were: hippies. A few of the estimated 16 million cultural rebels who abandoned 1950s notions about how life in America should be lived. And by 1968, almost everyone in America knew what these people were too: student protesters, activists, part of a small but vocal group of political rebels who were fighting not only to end a war, but to transform, even dismantle, the American system. And this is Jerry Rubin. To try to make sense of the 60s, you have to listen to what he was telling America in 1968.
You know, America is so obsessed with bad breath and with underarm deodorant. These are the biggest problems in the world. If you watch television at prime times, advertising is not concerned about poverty, not concerned about race oppression, not concerned about the police, but the biggest problem is your hair groomed, and what's it like under your arms, and do you have bad breath? And this is the American obsession. I think that a generation of kids which says, we don't care about your concepts of cleanliness, is a revolutionary generation.
Oh my God!
Hey, Brett,
you talking
about the billionaire over here?
Yeah, you play volleyball? I mean, you play basketball?
Oh, yes.
Oh, well.
With these little arms? We're not concerned about competition at all.
Oh, my God!
All right, you guys, I love it.
If the dinosaur's tail's on the fence, does that count? Tail counts. Tail counts.
Ready? 3, 2, 1, done.
Go get them, dinosaurs.
If parents were uncomfortable with the way their sons and daughters were beginning to look, imagine how confused they'd become when they saw how this younger generation was starting to behave.
The counterculture was just drenched with eroticism. The very act of having long hair is an act of sensuality.
the summer. It was the love that bought me into the hippie movement.
The Council for a Summer of Love proclaims a summer of love in the city of San Francisco. We believe that Haight-Ashbury is the focus of a universal spiritual awakening. The summer of love is an expression of this awakening. We call upon the world to help us celebrate the infinite holiness of life.
This is the dawning of the age of Aquarius, age of Aquarius, Aquarius, Aquarius.
For many, the height of the hippie movement was the Woodstock Art and Film Festival in upstate New York in 1969. Over 500,000 people showed up to this free concert where many famous bands played. The planners of the festival were not expecting so many people, and as a result, there was not enough food and medical supplies. The festival came to symbolize everything that the hippies stood for because everyone got along in a communal setting.
And everybody else that has volunteered and put in their time into the free kitchens. In fact, it's everybody. We're all feeding each other. We must be in heaven, man!
From OTR on the rocks. This is Flower Power. Float Captain Bill Fields. Thank you.
Hippies were all about peace and love, and that's something that is important for everyone to take to heart, no matter who you are and what generation you're from.
Second place Shawnee Division is awarded to OTR Flower Power!
Together.